Let's take a look at faults in Insight. Managing faults is done through the Faults tab in the Control Panel. In Insight, we have two general categories for fault items, named faults and unassigned sticks. Some people prefer to start by picking separate fault sticks and later combine them into faults when the structure becomes more clear. These independent picks are stored in a set of unassigned sticks. Once assigned to a named fault, Insight will connect the sticks and draw a surface. Let's begin by picking some segments in the 3D view. Enter edit mode by clicking the pencil icon. Left click to place the picks for a single fault stick. These picks are connected by straight lines. Double click on the final point to finish the stick. Start a new stick using the left click. As well as the 3D view, sticks can be picked in other views, such as the inline crossline view. If we set an inline increment of 50 inlines, we can quickly jump between locations using the arrow keys. This can help us pick the fault at regular intervals and easily compare the current pick with the previous one. On the new line, use the left click to draw the fault stick and double click to finish. Drag a mispicked point to a new location or right click to completely remove it. Fault intersections with the active horizontal slice, horizon, or both can be seen in the map view. Use the display parameters to choose intersection type. The 3D view is the perfect tool to visualize the forest of interpreted unassigned sticks. Rotating through 360 degrees clearly reveals alignment of sticks that could be combined to form three separate fault planes. Click the Add button in the top right corner of the control panel and select New Fault. Give your fault a name and choose the time domain. Repeat to create a second fault. It is possible to change the color, thickness, and other attributes of the fault using the Details panel. To start making changes, enter Edit mode by clicking the pencil icon. Right-click and select Move Fault Stick to the named fault, and in this case, West 2. This will assign it to the active fault in the control panel. Note that the fault picks can also be edited here. Another way to assign sticks is to left-click the unassigned stick and press the A key. Use Control with the left mouse button to select multiple fault sticks and press the A key to assign them all to the current fault. Oops, that doesn't look right. Let's unassign that stick by using the right mouse button and selecting Unassigned Fault Stick or by pressing the U key. In all section views, the computed surface is drawn as a dashed line, and any fault sticks that intersect the section are drawn as crosses. Select the second named fault and enter edit mode by clicking the pencil icon. Use Control with the left click to select all the sticks and use right click or A key to assign them. Adjust the view as required and repeat with the remaining sticks. Remember to check your work. If the seismic data shows a clear fault definition, you can create a fault name and interpret the segments directly. This time, the connected picks are colored by the active fault. Stepping forward through the inlines and picking another stick allows Insight to interpolate a surface between each stick, clearly seen in the 3D view and also as an intersection in the map view. Anytime a fault is changed, Insight automatically updates the fault surface. Remember, you can pick a fault on any combination of views. When using the inline crossline view, the fault is projected as a dashed line onto the next line. The projection distance is determined by the fault details in the control panel. Similarly, when you look at an uninterpreted line between two interpreted segments, you can see a projected dashed line guiding you to the correct fault location. Turn off the 3D seismic for a final check of the faults. If you have questions or would like to discover more, then visit our website at www.dug.com. And remember, have fun with Insight!